Today we shall discuss on function of random variables. In the previous section we have already studied about random variable, multi-dimensional random variable which is two-dimensional or three-dimensional random variable. In this section we discuss on function of random variable. So in this section we deal with techniques for obtaining the probability law or distribution for the set of output random variables. When the probability law of input random variables and the nature of the transformations are known. So in this case, if x is an input random variable, then probability law of random variable x is known, which is either exponential distribution or normal distribution, or in case of discrete random variable, binomial or Poisson or different random variable. So if probability distribution of input variable are known, then we obtain a technique to find the probability law for set of output random variables. Now, in the first part, function of one random variable. First, we discuss about the function of one random variable. Let x be a random variable associated with sample space Sx and a known probability distribution. In this case, the input random variable, if x is an input random variable, then their sample space is known and probability law is also known in that case. Let g be a scalar function, and g be a scalar function that maps points of sample space Sx into y of gx. So the distribution function g is a scalar function that maps each element of Sx of sample space into Sy. For a given outcomes, Xs is a number, x, and the another number specified which is by g of Xs is gx only. This number is the value of random variable y. Or we can write y of s or y of sample space equal to simply y, which is equal to g of x, and in this case scalar function g transform x into y, and sample space of gx or y is given by sy, where y equal to gx such that x is element of associated sample space xs. Now, if we want to know the probability law or probability distribution of any random variable, we started with the given condition. So, the probability density function of f of y, which is probability density function of y, random variable y, when probability distribution function of h or PDL of x is known. So, now let us derive a procedure to find probability density function of y. Given that when y equal to gx, where x is a continuous random variable, x is a continuous random variable with probability density function unknown, which is given by f of x, and g of x is a strictly monotonic function. Strictly monotonic function means either an increasing function or decreasing function. So we consider both the cases. In the first case, we consider g of x is a strictly increasing function of x. Or in this case, if x increases, then y also increases. And this is the example of a strictly increasing case. In case of x axis and y axis, we draw the y equal to g of x, then this is an increasing function. Now, in this case, community distribution function of y, by the definition of community distribution function, f of y or only f y is equal to probability of random variable y always less than or equal to a particular value. And here y equal to g of x, so we put y equal to g of x in this case. Now, x, g of x is a strictly increasing function, so their inverses exist in continuous case, and therefore probability of x is always less than or equal to g inverse y. G inverse represents inverse function of g, and if y equal to g of x is a continuous function, then their inverse also exists in this case. So g inverse y exists in this case, and therefore probability of x less than or equal to g inverse y, which represent commutative distribution function of random variable x for less than or equal to g inverse y. So here f in subscript x represent, this is the commutative distribution function of random variable or non-random variable x. Now if we differ, we want to find probability density function of random variable y. So it is differentiate the commutative distribution function of y in this case, which is given by fx g inverse y, where x equal to g inverse y. We can write x equal to, so f of x gx. Now we want to find probability density function by the commutative distribution function of the random variable y given. We differentiate it with respect to y, both the side. So in this case, left hand side converted to PDF function of y equal to, now fx g inverse y, if we differentiate it with respect to y, we get function of g inverse y into dx by dy, because the function inverse is x, is a function of x, so dx by dy, and here f of x dx by dy in this case. So probability density function of random variable y, when probability density function of random variable x is known and x and y associated with the function y equal to g of x, we get f of y equal to function of x into dx by dy, where x equal to g inverse y, and in which case where function is monotonically increasing or strictly increasing function. Now we consider the second case in which function is associated with a strictly decreasing function. In the second case, where gx is a, or function g is a strictly decreasing function of x, and in this case cumulative distribution function of random variable y equal to probability of y is less than equal to y, by the definition here probability of y equal to g of x. And in the next step, where probability of x greater than g inverse y, so in this case, if here inverse function of x, g of x is a strictly decreasing function, so their inverse function is always an increasing function, and in this case the sign should be changed in this case, and less than equal to converted into greater than or equal to sign, and therefore probability of x greater than equal to g inverse y is equal to 1 minus probability of x less than if here is greater than or equal to, then in this case only less than, or if here less than or equal to, then here only greater than sign. So in this case 1 minus total probability remains 1, so 1 minus probability of x less than or equal to g inverse 1, and which is a commutative distribution function of x of g inverse 1. So if we want to find the probability density function in this case of random variable y, we differentiate with respect to y both the side. In the left hand side we get PDF of y, and in the right hand side minus of probability density function of x into dx by dy. So if we combine previous result, the first case result and second case result, we get probability density function of random variable y, which is function of x, is equal to mod of dx by dy into function of probability density function of x. Or we can write dx by dy is equal to 1 by dy by dx, and which is equal to fx or g dash x with modulus value. Now, example related to function of one random variable. In the question, let x be continuous random variable with probability density function or probability log bound are given. In this case, is function of x equal to x by 12 in the interval x is greater than 1 and less than 5 and 0 elsewhere. Find the probability density function of y equal to 2x minus 3. Here, y equal to 2x minus 3, since y equal to 2x minus 3 given, and therefore x equal to y plus 3 divided by 2. Now, probability density function of one function of one random variable fy is given by probability density function of x into dx by dy, modulus value of dx by dy. So in this case, function of x equal to the probability density function of known random variable x is equal to x by 12 dx by dy. Here x equal to y plus 3 by 2, therefore dx by dy equal to 1 by 2, and therefore is equal to 1 by 2. Now, the density function for y, so first we convert x into y. Here x equal to y plus 3 by 2, so we put the value of x equal to y plus 3 by 2 into the density function of y. We get y plus 3 by 2, so 12 into 2, 24, and divided by 2, so 24. Now, the next part is find the range of random variable y. So, we find the range of random variable y with help of relation of x and y. If x equal to, so lowest limit of x is x equal to 1, and in this case, if x equal to 1, we put in the x equal to y plus 3 by 2, we get y equal to, if x equal to 1, then 2 equal to y plus 3 and y equal to minus 1 in this case. And in the case of greatest limit, x equal to 5, if you put x equal to 5 in this case, 5 plus 5 into 10 minus 3, y equal to 7. So range of random variable y is y greater than minus 1 and less than 7. So if probability law of a random variable x, given random variable x is known, and any random variable or output random variable which is a linear function of or single variable function of random variable x, then we can find the probability density function of output random variable with help of input random variable. Now, second case where one function of two random variables. In the previous case, one function of only one random variable. In this case, one function of two random variables. So, in this case, the range of random variable z, which is function of x and y both in an xy plane. So, we proceed to find the function of z in the following way. In which z is a given number. Z is a given number which is function of x square, and we can find a region dz in the xy plane such that all points in dz satisfy the condition z of xy is always less than or equal to z. So if z is less than equal to z for commutative distribution function, if range is z is less than equal to z, which means g of x y is less than or equal to z, and which implies x y is element of domain z. So it is clear that if z is a given number and z is a function of x and y, then we can find a region dz in x y plane such that all point of dz, all point of dz, z for z is less than or equal to z, x and y element of the given domain. function of z is, which means probability of z less than or equal to z is equal to probability of x, y element of dz, or probability of x and y which belongs to the domain of z, and which is given by, in case of continuous distribution, double integration in the domain dz of joint density function of random variable x, y with respect to x and with respect to y. Now, some theorem related to one function of two random variables. The first function is, if two random variables x and y, let x and y be two independent random variables, then the density function of their sum, that z is the sum of these two random variables x and y, z equal to x plus y, is given by convolution of their density functions. So x plus y, so in this case we want to find density function or distribution function of random variable x, z, which is sum of two independent random variable x and y. So if z equal to x, y, then cumulative distribution function of z is equal to double integration in the given domain dz of function of x, y, integrating with respect to x and integrating with respect to y. Now here, x varies from, in this case, x plus y equal to z this line and less than equal to z, so below the straight line x plus y equal to z, the given reason dz exists, because if x equal to 0 and y equal to 0, then 0 is less than equal to z, any positive value. So in this case, if treating y as a constant limit, y vary from minus infinity to plus infinity, because the line draw tends to an infinite value. And if we put assume x as a variable limit, then x vary from minus infinity. We draw a straight parallel to y axis, so that line does the or tends to a minus infinity value when x tends to minus infinity and x equal to z minus y, in this case, function of x, y, dx, dy. So, cumulative distribution function of sum of two independent random variable is equal to this, and if we differentiate it with respect to z, d minus infinity to infinity minus infinity to z minus y d by dz of function of x, y, joint density function of random variable x and y, dx, dy. Here dx is a, or x is a integration with respect to variable limits. So, minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to z minus y, integration with respect to joint density function fxy, dx by dz, dy. Now, here dx by dz, we can find dx by dz by z equal to x plus y, or x equal to z minus y. This implies that dx by dz, where y is a constant, in this case, and equal to 1. And which depends on here a constant value, so either negative or positive. If we have variable values, then in that case, mode of the dx by dz in this case, we assume. So here minus infinity to infinity, integration from minus infinity to infinity, dx by dz equal to 1 in this case. So integration with respect to function of x, y, integration with respect to y. First we integrate with respect to joint density function f of x, y. We get in this case minus infinity to infinity as it is. First we integrate, so in z minus y in this case, function of x, y minus infinity to z dy as it is. Now, in case of the upper limit, we get minus infinity to infinity as it is, function of x equal to z minus y, so we put z minus y, 1. minus in case of lower limit function of joint density function of xy equal to del square partial differentiation with respect to x and y of cumulative distribution function of x, y. Now if x equal to minus infinity in this case, then their cumulative distribution function tends to 0, and so function of xy equal to 0 at x tends to minus infinity. And therefore, commutative distribution function of z, which is sum of two independent random variable, is given by integration from minus infinity to plus infinity function of z minus y into y dy. Or we can write, because of x and y independent random variable, so their joint density function is equal to their marginal density function z minus y into function of y dy. Now, a particular case of or corollary in this case, if function of x less equal to 0 for x is less than 0 and function of y is equal to 0 when y is less than 0 and function of z minus y into function of y is not equal to 0, then the limit of y depends on z, and in this case y is less than z and greater than 0. Because if y is greater than z in this case, then this value becomes negative, and then in that case function of z minus y is equal to 0. So limit of y is greater than 0 and less than z in this case, and then the given result converted into 0 to z f of z minus y into function of y dy. Now second theorem, if two random variables x and y are independent random variables, then probability density function or multiplication of these two random variables is denoted by z equal to xy in term of density function of x and y is given by this. If we compare with the first case, for in the first case minus infinity to infinity function of xy dx by dz dy as a common result, or mode value of dx by dz. So in this case where z equal to x, y, then x equal to z by y, so dx by dz equal to 1 upon y with mod value. And so in this case probability density function of z is given by minus infinity to infinity function of xy in this case, an independent random variable, x equal to z by y, so z by y into dx by dz, mod value of dx by dz integrating with respect to y similarly. Because in this case is a parabolic function and lies between minus infinity to infinity, so we consider these two cases, which combined case represent mode value of 1 upon y. Because in the minus infinity to 0 case, we get minus 1 upon y, and 0 to infinity case, we get 1 upon y in this case. So similarly, by the previous result, we get the commutative distribution, or sorry, density function of random variable z, which is from multiplication of two independent random variables x and y, is equal to limit minus infinity to plus infinity mod of 1 by y marginal density function of x into marginal density function of y. And in the particular case, the marginal density function of x when x equal to z by y. And similarly, we can find if x and y independent random variable, then z and z is quotient of two random variables x and y, then their probability density function z is given by limit minus infinity to plus infinity mod of dx by dy. So x equal to z1, so dx by dz equal to y in this case, and their mod value is equal to mod of y. Random variable x and y are independent random variable, so function of x and x equal to z y y as it is dx d, sorry dy only for dx in this case according to the previous result. On x and y independent, so mod of y as it is marginal density function of x or z y into marginal density function of y integrating with respect to y in that case. So these are all examples of one function or two random variables. Now the next case is two functions of two random variables x and y. Here x and y are two independent random variables or two dimensional random variable, and z and w are another random variable which are the function of x and y, two different function of x and y. So if x and y are two dimensional random variable or probability density function with the joint probability density function, function of x, y, and z is a function of x and y and w is another function of x and y are two other random variables. So here z and w are also random variables, but these random variables are function of x and y. Then joint probability density function of z w equal to mod of z, j represent here Jacobian, which is partial differentiation of x y with respect to z and w, is or value of the Jacobians given by del x by del z or del x by del w or del y by del z, del y by del w. This is the determinant of partial differentiation of variable x with respect to z, with x with respect to w, and similarly for y with respect to z and y with respect to w. And this theorem holds good only if z and w, equation z and w when solved, give a unique value in x and y in term of z and w. If the function when we solve not give a unique value in this case, then we cannot find the joint density function of z w in term of density function of x and y. Now the example related to two function of two random variable x and y each follow exponential distribution with parameter 1. So x and y each follows exponential distribution with parameter 1 and are independent. So x is an exponential distribution with parameter lambda equal to 1, and y is also exponential distribution with parameter 1. Then find probability density function of u, which is function of x and y. So probability density function of x given by lambda into lambda equal to 1, here lambda equal to 1, so lambda into exponential of minus lambda x, which means exponential of minus x for x is greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. And probability density function of y also exponential distribution, so exponential of minus y when y is greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. Now x and y are independent, so joint density function of x, y equal to multiplication of their marginal density function, and which is equal to exponential of minus x into exponential of minus y when x and y both greater than 0. और विच इज इक्वल टू एक्सपोनेंशियल ऑफ माइनस ऑफ एक्स प्लस वाई सच दैट एक्स एंड वाई ग्रेटर देन जीरो एंड जीरो अदरवाइज. So this is the given part of the question where x and y follows exponential distribution. An exponential distribution of any function, density function, is equal to lambda into exponential of minus lambda x, where lambda is always greater than 0 and x greater than 0 in this case, and 0 other way. And are independent, so their joint density function is multiplication of their individual probability density function, and therefore joint density function of x and y is equal to exponential of minus x plus 1. Okay. Here x and u is the function of x minus 1. We can convert the random variable into two function of two random variable by assuming y equal to v in this case. So y equal to v, then and u equal to x minus y, then x equal to u plus v in this case, and y equal to v as it is, and therefore joint density function of z uv, equal to Jacobian's J of joint density function of x, y. So here first we find Jacobian. So Jacobian's J equal to del x by del u. Del x by del u, which means partially differentiate x with respect to u. So we get 1 in this case, partial differentiation of x with respect to u, treating v as constant is 1. In the next, it's a second element of the row, del x by del u, partially differentiate with respect to v, we get 1. Partially differentiate y with respect to u, 0. And partially differentiate y with respect to v, we get 1. So Jacobians of given variable is equal to 1. And therefore, joint density function of uv equal to mod of 1, which is equal to 1. Function of xy in this case, exponential of minus x plus y, or we convert x and y into u and v form, so we put x equal to u plus v and y equal to v, we get exponential of minus u plus v plus v, u plus 2v. Now the second part, the range of u and v. So here transformation in two random variables, in the first the x and y exist in first quadrant of the real numbers x, or first of xy plane, and transform g of xy into this form where u plus v equal to 0. Yeah. If x is greater than 0, x is greater than 0 in the given condition, so u plus v also greater than 0 in this case. And in second case, y is also greater than 0, so v is greater than 0 in this case. So if we draw u plus v equal to 0, which represents this line, u plus v equal to 0, and v equal to 0, which means u axis. So if x and y axis transform into u into v, u and v axis, then v equal to 0 represent u axis, or v equal to 0 in this case. And the reason is u plus v greater than 0, so above the line, and v is greater than 0, so above the line. So there are two reasons. In the first reason, where line variable u plus v equal to 0, and second, v is greater than 0 in this case. So range of u and v is given by v is greater than minus u, and v is and when u is less than 0, v is greater than minus u when u is less than 0, and v is greater than 0 when u is greater than 0. So in the second part reason, u and v both greater than 0, and in this case where v is greater than minus u, if u is less than 0. V is greater than minus u when u is less than 0. Now we want to find density function of u x minus y. So, and we know the joint density function of u, which is equal to exponential of minus u plus 2v. So we find marginal density function for u, which is equal to range of v integration of uv, or joint density function of uv with respect to v. By the definition of marginal density function, and range in this case of v dependent on, by the previous diagram, in the first region v is greater than minus u, and in second region v and u greater than 0 in this case. So density function of u is minus u to infinity, here minus u to infinity, the range of the given integration of joint density function. Now we put joint density function of random variable u and v, which is equal to exponential of minus u plus 2v. And exponential of minus u is a constant, integrate from minus u to infinity of exponential of minus 2v with respect to v, and which is equal to, if u is less than 0, is 1 upon 2, integration exponential of minus 2, as it is exponential of minus 2v equal to exponential of minus 2v by minus 2 and minus u to infinity. So in this case we get exponential of minus u as it is at infinity 0 and at the minus u. Exponent, if u is less than 0, then minus and minus plus, exponential of 2v upon 2, which is equal to 2u, sorry, exponential of u upon 2 when u is less than 0, and in case when u is greater than 0, then exponential of minus u 1 upon 2 exponential of minus 2 when u is greater than 0. So we can find the joint density function, or with help of two functions of two random, by assuming one variable as a independent another variable. If u equal to x plus y, then we can assume y equal to v and convert into two function of two random variable and find the joint density function of random variable u and v, and then with help of joint density function of uv, we find marginal density function of random variable u, which is the given part of, which is the required part of the question.